Welcome guys to the stream. We're gonna play some Stardust Order 7 again. This is more like a relaxed sort of game, one where you can just sit down, do basically nothing. I've done a little bit of work on it, but not much. Hey Chris, how are you? There we go, now I have the right screen up. There we go. If you guys like what you see, don't forget to smash the like button and also subscribe if you'd like to see more.
They're ready. And they're racing. Little Big Horn starts slowly. Forest Edge is pushed along to an early lead. Jubawi Sound races freely in second. Forest Edge is pushed into the lead again from Jubawi Sound. Forest Edge leads from Jubawi Sound just clear of Little Big Horn ahead of Key Ambition in last position, racing right-handed. Forest Edge is one length ahead of Jubawi Sound, a gap to Little Big Horn and then Key Ambition in last position. Forest Edge heads the pack by a length. Less than 1,200 meters to go. Forest Edge is in front from Jubawi Sound, a gap to Key Ambition just clear of Little Big Horn in last position. They have less than 1,000 meters to go. Key Ambition brings up the rear. Jubawi Sound is pushed into the lead from Forest Edge. Forest Edge is pushed into the lead, racing right-handed. Forest Edge leads from Jubawi Sound, a gap to Key Ambition and then Little Big Horn in last position. They have less than 600 meters to go.
Go now.
Forest Edge is one length ahead of Jubawi Sound, two lengths to Key Ambition, next is Little Big Horn in last position. Forest Edge leads and is middled along by a length. They have less than 200 meters to go. Forest Hedge is a length clear of New Bally Sound. Forest Hedge is the winner.
Possibly suited as riding as a stalker. Trip suited and the ground. The horse loved the ground. Okay. Well, that was everything for today. Now we go back to here. Skip to the 11th. And see how our 2-year-old goes.
They're under starter's orders. And they're racing. John's spirit starts slowly. High Life Dancer leads from Abshire's Inaga to Ovis Inaga back to Trafalgar ahead of Valbra from Penidor Roda. The field is well strung out. High Life Dancer is in front from Abshire's Inaga to Ovison, going left-handed. High Life Dancer leads the way by 2. Trafalgar is making headway. Trafalgar goes okay back in the pack, about 8 lengths off the pace. High Life Dancer has a clear lead from Avison, a gap to Obshirzane, a gap back to Trafalgar, a gap to Offal Brav, a gap back to John Spirit, clear of Penidor Roda in last position. They have less than 400 metres to go. They have less than 200 metres to go. Trafalgar goes into the lead. Trafalgar is 2 lengths in front of High Life Dancer. Trafalgar is the easy winner.
To be able to get something for its denim. No, I don't. Wait, I clicked the wrong thing. That one. There we go. Now. Hello, Ian. To be honest, man, it's been raining on and off it all day. I'm just on the outskirts of Blue Mountains, so I'm getting everything from the Blue Mountains, and at the moment it's thunderstorms. Possibly until the end of the week. How's the weather where you are, Ian? 0. I don't need to. Skip. And go. It's hot, but rain for the next week. If you get the rain we get, dude, expect a lot of rain. In the last 2 days, we've had close to, I reckon, at least 15-20 mils in the last 2 days. Yeah, but in Queensland, you guys have two seasons, wet and dry. And when it's dry, it's very hot. I was actually expecting us to have a hot summer this year, but I guess we're going to get rain most of this summer. It's nice if we could at least get one day without rain so I can mow the lawn. Like, I need to mow my lawn, but I can't because it's been raining for the last few days, and
they are under starter's orders in the group to turn those stakes. They're off.
Yeah, so really with Queensland,
the lemon started slowly. Bob's ticket is restrained in the lead. Jubawi's sound is driven to lead early on. Medicine Man is racing keenly in the rear. Jubawi's sound leads under restraint. Bob's ticket is making headway from over a length off the pace. Jubawi's sound is the leader from Medium Man, a gap back to the Hlemmon ahead of Bob's ticket. Next is Medicine Man. They have less than 1,600 metres to go. Medium Man leads from Jubawi's sound, the gap to the Hlemmon. Next is Medicine Man, a gap to Bob's ticket back to Mario, and then Genoa from Kingpin the Light, a gap back to Country Waltz in last position. Medium Man leads the way. Medium Man is in front from Jubawi's sound, the gap to the Hlemmon from Medicine Man just clear of Bob's ticket. Less than 1,200 metres to go. Genoa is anchored in the rear about 4 lengths off the pace. They have less than 1,000 metres to go. Medicine Man is pushed along mid-division. Bob's ticket is improving easily on the outside in third position. They have less than 800 metres to go. Jubawi's sound goes okay. The Hlemmon is pushed along towards the rear. They have less than 600 metres to go. Medium Man is pushed along in the lead by a length. Medium Man is 1 length ahead of Jubawi's sound. Less than 400 metres to go. Medium Man is 1 length ahead of Jubawi's sound. Medium Man is a length up on Jubawi's sound. They have less than 200 metres to go. Bob's ticket goes into the lead. Bob's ticket is a length clear of Genoa. Genoa has a flat. Genoa wins.
To be honest, surprised you haven't gotten it yet. Suited us perfectly. Okay. I'll do this race first.
They're ready. And they're racing. Clone Boy Girl starts slowly. Delightfully is racing behind the leaders. Galloping Queen leads under restraint. Try Catch Me is driven to lead early on. The field is tightly packed. Try Catch Me ups the tempo. Derglin is racing behind the leaders. Galloping Queen takes up the running from Drake Catch Me. They have less than 800 meters to go. Racing left-handed. Delightfully is pushed along towards the rear. Galloping Queen is the leader from Drake Catch Me. Next is the Cornish Cowboy. They have less than 600 meters to go. The favourite appears to be going well. Delightfully is pushed along in midfield. Galloping Queen is one length ahead of Metropolitan Miss. Trafalgar is making headway. Metropolitan Miss goes into the lead. Delightfully goes into the lead. Delightfully has a fractional lead from Trafalgar. Delightfully takes it.
I will quickly turn the sound down. Give me one sec, guys.
Volume set. Volume set.
That should be a little bit better. Well, what time do you guys normally start getting cyclones for your area? The game should be a little bit softer now, Ian. You came second on that one. What did he say? Suited perfectly. Okay, so everything suited perfectly for that one. Beginning of summer. Yeah, so you would have already gotten it. How have I been? Slept most of the day away. You're welcome, man. Just make sure you stay safe when it comes. Just make sure you stay safe, Ian. That's all we care about. As long as you're safe. Another one of them. I always do. Well, that's good. Oh, he came third in that race. Oh, they say he's group one winner. Okay. Excuse me. I got two races today. I still have him on YouTube, but I just don't watch that much anymore. And I don't think I have him on Twitch, because I don't go on Twitch much anymore. Because with my computer now, when I run my cookie cleaner through, it signs me out automatically. And I haven't yet worked out how to change that so it doesn't. So I've always got to keep signing myself back in. And to be honest, now I can't be bothered to sign back in every day that I want to go on Twitch. It's just too much effort. But then with YouTube now, if you don't watch them all the time, they also take away your notifications off them. So I don't even get notifications if he posts on YouTube anymore. Does he still post on YouTube, Ian?
They're ready. And they're off. Single and dwelt. Swooping Hawk is racing just off the pace. On the Nile takes it up from Foolish Party. Singland is last and is around 3 lengths.
Because
off
if
the
he still uploads on YouTube after the after my stream, I might
Rocker is
can you see why I'm not getting notifications for him anymore?
Swooping Hawk takes over. Less than 800 meters to go. Racing left-handed. Foolish Party is pushed into the lead again. Foolish Party leads from Swooping Hawk and then on the Nile gap back to Vienna Star. Next is Science Fiction, just clear of a Rocker. Swooping Hawk takes up the running once more from On the Nile. On the Nile goes into the lead once more. Swooping Hawk goes into the lead once more. Less than 400
Wait, Dark Knight doesn't do
go.
It anymore?
On the
Why?
Nile
do you know?
Up again from Dot Swooping Hawk. Swooping Hawk goes into the lead once more. They have less than 200 meters to go. Same length runs on late. Swooping Hawk is too the favorite. Swooping Hawk.
You've been watching Ando. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Ando would. Probably won't stop doing it for sure, because he really likes it. I wonder why he stopped. Your ground suited us perfectly, but yet you came fourth. Okay. That's understandable. Now, next.
All in.
I should win this. There's only three other horses.
Ash's Star was slowly away. Trickity's races a little freely in third. Dream Eater is pushed into the early lead. Racing left-handed.
Love
Ash's Star brings up the rear.
Big code 12.
Jubawi Sound is making headway. Dream Eater is 1 length ahead.
Wait, that means
Starkmire
probably doesn't go on 5M at all anymore either, would he?
Less than 1,600
in Ando stream, yeah. I think I've probably watched Ando once or twice.
Sound clear of Trickity's.
Back when Darkmire was streaming.
Trickity's is stone last and is around 8 lengths off the lead.
I wonder if my bot is working.
Dream Eater is the leader from Dubawi Sound, a few lengths to Ash's Star, just clear of Trickity's in last position. Going left-handed. They have less than 1,000 meters to go. Dream Eater leads from Dubawi Sound, clear of Ash's Star, a few lengths to Trickity's in last position. Dream Eater goes nicely. They have less than 800 meters
Fine,
to
I'll
go.
Try this command, because I know this one works.
Dream Eater is the leader from Dubawi Sound, clear of Ash's Star.
Yeah, Eagle, I haven't seen him for ages.
Turning left-handed.
It's almost like he just dropped out of the blue, to be honest.
Dubawi Sound comes there strongly on the outside. They have less than 400 meters to go. Dubawi Sound now just leads. Dubawi Sound is 1 length ahead of Dream Eater. Dubawi Sound is ridden into the lead.
Okay, it looks like my butt don't want to work right now.
Ash's Star is 1 length ahead of Ash's
Star. There you go,
like
now you
want to
work.
Ash's Star wins easily.
I'll have to fix that up afterwards. Right, let's see if this command works, otherwise I'm gonna have to deal with my commands later. Oh, so do I. I really missed what be able to watch Eagle. It used to be funny with Eagle, especially his insta toes, just because he couldn't be bothered to wait for another tow truck to turn up. So I guess some of my commands work, not all. How have you been here yet?
Hope you had a good Christmas.
Sorry, hope you had a good Christmas, Ian. Wow, very first race. I just checked Twitch, no duck my game. Okay then. What about YouTube? Does he still have a YouTube? Otherwise then he's stopped gaming altogether. That's good. My Christmas was good but wet.
And they're racing. The Lux has started slowly. To you, Barry Sound leads under a straight. Dubawi Sound leads from Seeking Magic from Biloxi back to Lake Honiston just clear of Westerner in last position. The pace is steady and the field is well packed. Racing right-handed.
I'll change the view. Right, I'm number one on this race. So I'm the one with green
Seeking
and yellow.
Is the leader from Biloxi from Dubawi Sound.
This one here is me.
In last position. Seeking Magic leads. Seeking Magic is the leader from the Lux.
Okay, so he's still on YouTube. He might have just stopped going on Twitch, to be honest.
He takes it up from dot Seeking Magic. Seeking Magic is pushed into the lead again from the Luxie. Dubawi Sound is pushed into the lead from Seeking Magic. They have less than 1,000 meters to go. Biloxi is running a quiet race.
After the stream, I might see if I'm still getting notifications for him. Same as watching Darkmire, who's a good, he was a good bloke. Probably still is a good bloke, I imagine.
Going right-handed.
This horse last before this race, Ian, just before you came in. The reason why I told him to go a little bit earlier is because he won by 3 lengths. So he's... The horse is able to do it.
Has a clear lead from Seeking Magic just clear of the cornest and
as we see here, now he's just taking off.
Back to Westerner in last position. They have less than 400 meters to go. Westerner is taking a long way around. Less than 200 meters to go. Dubawi Sound is clear easily.
Yeah, I've got this, no problem.
Six lengths in front of Westerner. The favourite. Dubawi Sound takes it well.
Well, I think that was an understatement. Well, this horse definitely still has the stamina. That's good. So this horse might be on its in its time of peak. Didn't have a race, so I can skip this race. Skip the day. Right, so if I go back to you, and it was the other horse that won by a length, he just won by 3. Alright, so Let's go back for a minute. Actually, I didn't want to go back that far. Right, so... yeah, his denim is improving. What about his, thing? It was a bit rude to me because... wow! Really? Well, I guess he definitely would be rude to me then, because I've been with the Cuffs for 4 years. You can say ever since Darkmire was in Cuffs, that's when I was there. But then he left because of time frame, but yet... it works out the time frame that it is. It works out to be the exact same time I am, which is at like midday 1 o'clock. Well, not being rude, but if you're gonna stream until like 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, well, yeah, of course you won't be awake in time for then, because you're the one that's streaming so late. It was never Cuff's fault that he was not able to make all the streams. He was streaming until early hours of the morning. Oh, Kenji was funny, yes. I miss Kenji, but, yeah, unfortunately he's no longer in it. Kenji was always funny. You're 102 now, so I'll chuck you in that race then. Wait, who rode you last? Shit. T. Wolf Graham. Okay. Nope. See, Graham. No, I can't get him. Okay. Anyone else say no? Bowman hasn't won that many. Oliver. No, that's JD. Has only won 5 6th season. McAvoy's won 3. Alright, I'll put C. Graham on him and see how he goes. Oh, should I skip that race? I wasn't meant to do that. Alright. Well, I can't. Okay then. Struggled in that class, be it you just won in that class. Okay. That's a bit random, but okay. Struggled in the class, be it you just won in that class. I have a character moment, but... oh, don't be nervous, my friend. Don't be nervous to start role-playing him. How well do you go in that one? And then you haven't raced for 49 days, so you've had a 49 day spell. I'll probably give you another month, so go there. T. Wolf Graham, definitely. Get on him. I want to see how you go on him. And then I should be able to put you on you as well. Yes, I can. Awesome. Wolf Graham on you. Now skip. What I've realized with the Cuffs crew, again, is never be nervous to start role-playing someone. They will always accept you. No matter who you're role-playing or what you're role-playing as, they always accept who you are.
All in. And they're racing. Eduardo Dwelled. Yubawi Sound is urged into the early lead. Digger gets lucky, races freely in fifth, turning left-handed. Eduardo has quickened into the lead. Eduardo leads from Yubawi Sound a few lengths to Hurricane Jack. Next is Digger gets lucky, a gap to OEC Virtue in last position. They have less than 1,600 meters to go. Easy Virtue is stone last. Eduardo is the leader. Eduardo is the leader from Dubawi Sound a few lengths to Hurricane Jack, and then Digger gets lucky, just clear of Easy Virtue in last position. Eduardo is pushed into the lead again from Dubawi Sound, turning left handed. Eduardo is the leader from Dubawi Sound, clear of Hurricane Jack, back to Digger gets lucky. Dubawi Sound is pushed into the lead.
Okay,
again.
My character's name is
Easy
John Rue, ex-military officer from Liberty Stories. Definitely.
Dubawi Sound is one length ahead of Eduardo, clear of Hurricane Jack. Agato Digger gets lucky.
Most definitely, I reckon I'd like that, especially considering it's John Rue.
Dubawi Sound forges on in the lead. They have less than 600
meters. Can he keep it though? That's what I want
to
know. Because if this horse loses it, it means he can't stay
in
some class.
Eduardo clear of Hurricane Jack. The gap to Digger gets lucky. Next is Easy Virtue in last position. Racing left-handed. Yubawi Sound is 3 lengths in front of Eduardo.
Nah, I'm losing it, eh?
Eduardo finishes fast. They have less than 200
go
meters.
Go on, start taking the lead again.
Yubawi Sound has taken a long by.
Take the lead.
Yubawi Sound is a length up on Eduardo.
There we go.
Yubawi Sound wins.
So Red is Dorka, never in doubt. Lovely horse, this trip was ideal. Right, so this horse can definitely do 2,000 meters. Okay. Then I believe this horse does 1,200. Get the ID from a kangaroo. And my middle name. Haha! That's always the best though, when you're able to get like an ID for a name by using some of your name or even like something that's close to where you come from. Example, what you did with John Rue, with the ID coming from Kangaroo. It's actually quite a smart idea.
They're ready. And they're racing. Zafonic Star leads up early. Classic Voice races freely in third. Maccabees races a little freely in sixth. Zafonic Star is keen in first. Zafonic Star is in front from Trafalgar, back to Classic Voice, and then Crumpet Sportive ahead of a Key Petal, Agato, Anastasia.
You're welcome,
and then
Maccabees
just clear of Penadour Roda in last position.
If you also want to do a run with me, let me know and I'll jump on and we'll be able to do runs together.
Trafalgar is in front from Classic Voice from Zafonic Star, just clear of a Key Petal, back to Crumpets Fortia. Classic Voice is driven to lead. Trafalgar coming there on the inside. They have less than 400 meters to go. Maccabees goes into a 2-length lead. Maccabees is 3 lengths clear of classic boys. Maccabees has 3 in hand of Trafalgar. Less than 200 metres to go. Maccabees goes into a 4 length lead. Maccabees looks
that's
like
fine, man.
Maccabees is 5 lengths in front of classic.
That's perfectly fine, my friend. May do better against less competition. Okay. I think I need to wait for that horse to go at least 3. So it's gonna have a while off, I think. This horse is a group 1. Let's see how well he goes in this. Put Bowman on him this time, see how well Bowman goes. Now skip. Quickly see what's on. Sale is breeding. I'll skip the auction.
They are under starter's orders in the Group 1 Grand at Stakes. And they are racing. Bob's ticket is urged into the early lead.
There, okay.
Usamra is anchored in the rear. The pace appears to be strong and the field well strung out. Jubawi Sound makes progress. Bob's ticket is in front from Musical Valley, just clear.
Well, I know at the moment I'm not able to stream, but once I'm able to stream, yeah, we'll definitely jump on together and I'll stream it for us. But
meters to go.
We're always allowed to record. So if you want to record a couple of runs, let me know.
Bob's ticket is pushed into the lead from Musical Valley.
But I'm pretty sure you have to be whitelisted at the moment if you're not already.
Division a couple of lengths off the pace. They have less than 1,200 meters to go. Campanero makes progress. Bob's ticket is pushed into the lead again from Musical Valley.
Oh, well, I'm staying me first.
Sound next is Musical Valley, just clear of Wishes or Watches, clear of Busamara, just clear of Campanero, the gap to Country Waltz, next is Kingpin the Light. Less than 1,000 meters to go. Yubawi Sound kicks on for home. They have less than 800 meters to go. Wedding Party is making headway. Intros is racing midfield about 7 lengths off the pace. They have less than 600 meters to go. Intros is pushed along towards the rear. Bob's ticket is pushed along towards the rear. Jubawi Sound is a length.
Nah, I'll lose
wedding
it.
Party. Wedding Party,
yeah.
Now just
this
leads.
Is where I'll lose it.
Wedding Party is 1 length ahead of Musical
Valley. I think applications are open at the moment. I'm not 100% sure. You'll have to check the Discord.
Wedding Party is pushed along in the lead by 2.
Alright, Ian. I'll see you when you come back.
Wedding Party takes it.
Yeah, okay. So we're outclassed. Yeah, obviously. Oh shit, that was real bad, that race.
under orders.
Dear off.
Silence out of wind will. Jubawi Sound is pushed into the early lead. Jubawi Sound is 2 lengths ahead of Stelia Gap back to in Grace's view ahead of Silent Valley, next is Lidar and then Silent Sourwind in last position. The field is strung out and the base appears to be good. Less than 1,600 metres to go. Jubawi Sound is the leader from Stelia Gap to Olidar, next is in Grace's view from Silent Sourwind, next is Silent Valley in last position.
Ugh.
Jubawi Sound is 2 lengths ahead of Stelia Gap to Olidar, just clear of in Grace's view. Jubawi Sound leads the way by 2. Jubawi Sound is 2 lengths clear of Steely, just clear of Lidar, the gap back to Silent South in the gap to Silent Valley ahead of in Grace's view in last position. Jubawi Sound is 2 lengths in front of Steely, just clear of Lidar. Jubawi Sound leads the way easily. The favourite is going backwards and is 8 lengths off the pace. They have less than 600 metres to go.
8 lengths off the pace, that's not so good for a favourite.
Jubawi Sound is 4 lengths clear of Staley, a few lengths to Silent Valley.
Okay, I'm starting to lose it now.
View. Less than 400 metres to go.
Come
Silent
on,
Valley
keep first, keep first.
Progress.
No, I'll lose first.
Jubawi Sound is red in the lead. Less than 200.
Probably
going to
come third, I think.
Staley,
I think I called it too early.
Along into the lead. Staley is a length clear of Jubawi Sound.
Yeah, I called it too early.
Here comes Jubawi Sound. And that is a close one between Staley and Silent Valley.
Ooh, maybe. Nah, third.
Under orders for the group 3, the Jans. And they're racing. Daytona is anchored in the rear. Rosalie and Fine is racing keenly in the rear. Faraway is pushed into an early lead from La Rapale. Brunswick Vale is under pressure out the back. Pantella is making headway from over 4 lengths off the lead. Alisakna is pushed along
go,
the field, about 5 lengths off the pace. Less than 800 metres to go. Rosalie Arthur is pushed along in midfield. Faraway is the leader from La Rapale, a few lengths to Rosalie Arnfine ahead of Pantella. Next is Alisakna A from Trafalgar. They have less than 600 metres to go. Faraway leads by 2 lengths and is nickled along. They have less than 400 metres to go. Faraway is 2 lengths clear of La Rapale. Faraway is just ahead of Rosalie Arnfine. Rosalie Arnfine now leads. They have less than 200 metres to go. Rosalie Arnfine is just ahead of Brunswick Vale. Brunswick Vale is the winner.
Against Lesser again. Okay then. But you're only 2 years old, that's why.
They are ready to go in the Group 1 Singapore Airlines Cup. And they are racing. Lovers' talk started slowly. Hot Doris driven into the early lead by a length. Racing left-handed. Shift change over is racing behind the leaders. Hot leads from Beautiful Lando, just clear of shift change over next is Jubawi Sound, just clear of Weybridge Light, just clear of Lover's Talk. Less than 1,600 metres to go. Hyperlink is pushed along towards the rear. Hot Dodd is one length in front of Beautiful Lando, just clear of Jubawi Sound, back to shift change over, just clear of Weybridge Light. Jubawi Sound is back in the chasing pack. Hot Dodd is the leader from Beautiful Lando, a gap back to shift change over, next is Jubawi Sound, a gap from Lover's Talk, back to Weybridge Light, a gap back to Farah and from Crystal Power, next is Hyperlink in last position. They have less than 1,200 metres to go. They have less than 1,000 metres to go. Going left-handed. Hyperlink is pushed along out the back. Crystal Power races wide. Less than 800 metres to go. Weybridge Light is making ground from the rear. Hyperlink is pushed along in last and is some 7 lengths off the pace. Less than 600 metres to go. Hot Dodd is in front from Lover's Talk, back to Weybridge Light, and then Beautiful Lando next to Jubawi Sound.
Okay, he's done to drop, that's not good.
They have less than 400 metres to go. Hot Dodd is 3 lengths clear of Weybridge Light. Weybridge Light is making headway. Hot Dodd leads the way easily. Less than 200 metres to go. Lover's Talk runs on late. Hot Dodd is a length clear of Lover's Talk. Faggot and a lead. Faggot takes it.
Nope. Dead last. Okay. No chance out there. Welcome back, Ian. You didn't miss out on too much except for me coming dead last. So it's okay. Said skip, thank you.
They're under starter's orders. And they're racing. Zelzel was slowly away. Get It On leads up early by a length. Racing right-handed. Get It On leads from Jubawi Sound, just clear of Zelzel, and then Paris House in last position. Get It On ups the tempo. Get It On leads from Jubawi Sound, a gap back to Zelzel, a gap to Paris House in last position. Get It On takes up the running once more from Jubawi Sound. Paris House is last. Get It On is the leader from Jubawi Sound, a gap back to Zelzel, 2 lengths to Paris House in last position. Get It On is the leader from Jubawi Sound, and then Zelzel, a gap to Paris House in last position. They have less than 1,200 metres to go.
turning right-handed. Get it on the, is the leader from Zilzal back to Jubawi Sound, two lengths back to Paris House in last position. Zilzal is pushed into the lead. Jubawi Sound travels well. Jubawi Sound is pushed into the lead from Zilzal. They have less than 800 metres to go. Get it on is making headway. The favourite needs to find some space. Jubawi Sound is one length in front of Get It On a Gap to Zilzal from Paris House in last position. Racing right-handed. Get It On is the leader from Jubawi Sound, just clear of Paris House, two lengths to Zilzal in last position. They have less than 400 metres to go. Get It On is ridden into the lead.
You've got it, come on, boy.
Get It On is pushed along in the lead by a length. They have less than 200 metres to go. Get It On is two lengths clear of Jubawi Sound. Get It On has to. Get It On takes it. The favourite wins.
Didn't make it there, and I didn't make it there. Okay. Let's see how well it goes in a championship, actually. It was group one? Apparently no group. So where are you going that then? Shit, I'd accidentally skipped my race. Oh, I would. Oh, or struggled in that grade, okay. Might actually sell you and get an next auction. Let's make it even 55,000, or 155,000.
They're ready. They're off. Richmond is racing at the back a couple of lengths off the pace. I'm right is pushed along to an early lead. I'm right is racing keenly in third. Midsummer Sun is the leader from Jenny's Gold, a gap to I'm right back to Buffett, a gap back to Charente River ahead of Richmond, a gap to Bastiano. Jenny's Gold takes up the running from Midsummer Sun. Midsummer Sun is driven to lead again. Plenty of pace on early and they are strung out. Richmond moves through the pack. Elovamo is way back. Midsummer Sun is the leader from Jenny's Gold, just clear of I'm right, a gap back to Buffett, just clear of Charente River from Richmond, just clear of Warrior Wings ahead of Sebastiano, back to Elovamo in last position. Less than 1,600 metres to go. Warrior Wings brings up the rear. Midsummer Sun is pushed into the lead. Warrior Wings is racing at the back about 9 lengths off the pace.
Good now.
Midsummer Sun is in front for James Gold, the gap to him right.
This
gap
may be my last
the
race,
gap to
and then
River just
I will be like
Richmond,
to
gap
tomorrow
back
to
Elvamo.
Catch up on the stream I didn't do
they
yesterday.
Have less than 1,200
I've
meters
been going
to go.
Live for, James
Gold is pushed into the lead again from Midsummer
minutes.
Sun. Jenny's Gold is the leader from Midsummer Sun.
But we'll
gap
see how well
I
go
right
before
ahead
I
ahead
decide
of
if
two
it's
lengths
last race
to Charente River. Next is Richmond, a few lengths to Sebastiano from Elovamo, a few lengths to Warrior Wings in last position. Midsummer Sun is driven to lead again, turning right-handed. Sebastiano is under pressure out the back. Jenny's Gold now leads. Midsummer Sun is pushed into the lead again. Sebastiano is improving. Warrior Wings is pushed along towards the rear. Less than 400 meters to go. Jenny's Gold is one length ahead of Midsummer Sun, a gap back to Richmond, a gap to him right, a few lengths to Sebastiano. They have less than 200 meters to go.
Guess I said to go at the right time.
Is moving along into a lead. Richmond is two lengths in front of Iron Bight.
Okay, so who won that one? Never a moment doubt. Okay. I'll do one more race and then I'm gonna end this one. Who raced him just then? Eskima. So he's booked for tomorrow or for today's race.
They are ready to go in the Group 1 Victoria Derby. And they're off. Richmond, well. Nancy Eason is racing behind the leaders.
It's raining,
Pascal is
so
pushed into an early lead from Subtle Affair.
Soft track. I don't know
Flames
how well it will go
it
on soft. That's the problem.
River Grand is pushed into the early lead. They are strung out like washing. Flames
yeah,
Boy
I
is making headway
like
from
washing.
A length off the pace. Celtic Silhouette brings up the rear.
There I am.
Miserka is racing mid-division. Duke of Rainford is making headway. Flint Boy is making ground. River Grand is two lengths ahead of Nikos Extra from Flint Boy and then Pascal just Rickard Grant is one length in front of Fasco, and then Nikos Ekstra from Flensboy, two lengths clear of Sakiel, just clear of Richmond, the gap back to Savita, gap back to Subtle Affair, just clear of Duke of Rainford, just clear of Champs de Blue. Less than 1,600 metres to go. Celtic Silhouette is under pressure out back. Magic Legs is pushed along in last. Savita is making ground. River Grand leads from Pascal Gap to Flamesboy, back to Nikos Ekstra, two lengths to Sakiel, next was Richmond, just clear of Savita, just clear of Subtle Affair from Duke of Rainford.
Now go.
Sakiel has not been asked a question yet, about five lengths off the pace. Sakiel looks to be going well. Chosen Man is racing mid-division. Mizerka is under pressure out the back. River Grand is one length clear of Basque, gap back to Flensboy, just clear of Savita, back to Nikos Ekstra. Less than 600 metres to go. Magic Legs is making headway. River Grand leads from Pascal Gap Top Savvy to ahead of Flensboy, ahead of Nikos Ekstra. Pascal now leads. Less than 400 metres to go. Pascal is a length up on Savita. Savita is running on. Pascal is a length clear of Savita. Less than 200 metres to go. Pascal is pushed along on the lead. Savita hits the front. Pascal is driven to lead again. Pascal is the winner.
Oh no, I struggled in this class, okay. Oh, grade. Alright guys, I'm going to be ending it here, and I will catch you guys on tomorrow's stream, and I will post a link in my Discord and in a couple other people's Discords as well. If you guys would like to come and watch, if you liked what you saw today, make sure you like and subscribe to see more, and to make sure you don't miss out on tomorrow's live stream as well. Alright, see you guys.